best way to understand graphs is just to get started. So let's start and create our first graph. So here we've got some data, the months, and the bills. It's as simple as we highlight the area, and under the Insert tab, you'll see there's a number of chart items. For now, we're going to just choose one. We'll go to column, I'll click on it, and all the different kind of column charts appear. For simplicity's sake, we're just going to click on this 2D column chart. When I click it, the chart is created. A couple of observations. You'll see Excel has made some assumptions about this data and included it in the chart. So it's got its access levels. You'll see it's decided that the dates belong down here, etc. You'll also note that when you clicked on a chart, a new item appears in the ribbon called Chart Tools, and you'll see it consists of the Design, Layout, and Format. We're going to go through these in details, but note that when you click on a cell outside the chart, it disappears. To get it back, you click on the chart, and it reappears. Let's now work through this ribbon just to understand what the buttons do. So starting at the far left here, you'll see the first button says Change Chart Type. At the moment we have a column chart. If I click on that, you'll see we get the choice to change to any type of chart we want. So for example, let me change to a line chart, and when I say OK, you'll see the chart changes. If I want, I can go back, and we'll get to understand the different chart types later. Another option we have here is something called Save as Template. We will explain it later, but basically what it allows you to do is to create a template of the chart you want, and then whenever you need it, you can access it via Change Chart Type. The next set of buttons relate to the data, and you'll see the first button says Switch the Row and the Column. And basically what it's doing is Excel, because of the data setup, has decided that the months belong on the horizontal axis and the amounts belong on the vertical axis. If we click Switch Row and Column, you'll see what it does. It has now changed so that the horizontal axis represents the bill in total. The vertical still has the numbers, but now a legend actually gives us the breakdown of the months. It's quite useful when you create a chart just to click this button and to see which one is a better representation of what you're trying to achieve. The next button is the Select Data button. When you set up your chart, you've selected some data and created it. If you want to make some sort of a change and you click Select Data, you'll see you get a couple of options. First thing it tells you is where the chart data is. So if you want to change that, you can change it. You also have this button here saying Switch Row and Column, which does exactly the same thing as this button. You'll see what you can do as well is for the legend entries, you can add, edit, or remove an entry. So at the moment we only have one, the bull. If I say edit, it shows me where it's getting the series name from. So you'll see it's coming from there, and where the values are coming from there. If you need to edit it, you just make the change you want. You can either type them in, or else link them to the spreadsheet. You can add, and we'll show you a little bit later how to do that. And if needs be, you can remove. If you have a number of items here, you can use these arrows to move them up and down and decide in what order they should appear. You can also decide on what the horizontal axis will be. At the moment, it's looking at this column of data. So if I click Edit, you'll see it tells you that the x-axis, that's where it's getting its information from. If you want to change it, you just make the change here. You'll also note that there's an option at the bottom here called Hidden and Empty Cells. If I click on it, what it allows you to do is to decide what must the chart do if it discovers that one of these points is empty. Must it show it as a gap? So literally there'll just be nothing here. or must it show it as a zero, in which case if you had a line chart it would be going up and then plummet down and start up again. And you'll see you've also got the option of show data in hidden rows and columns. So, okay, we're happy with all of this. There we go. One of the major benefits of Excel 2007 is that a lot of work has been done on the visual display of the data. And with that in mind, you'll see the chart layout allows you to choose particular chart layouts. So if I click here, you'll see there's a whole bunch of predefined chart layouts. Now every one of these you could create on your own, but this is just a nice shortcut way to get there. So just looking at this, that one looks fairly nice. If I click on it, you'll see it's formatted in a certain way. We've got a data table here. Maybe I'd prefer this one here. And you'll see the formatting changes. And what you can use these for is to get it closer to what you want to achieve and then edit only the points you want to differentiate from. But for now, we're just going to go back to the standard chart. You'll also notice that there's a whole bunch of new chart styles. What this means is that you can choose any one of these color combinations to show your chart as. So for example, let's do this one here. And you'll see with one click, you can make a really professional looking chart with a little bit of shading, 3D look and feel, nice colors, etc. You can see any possible combination of these you can do. So let's just look at a few more. Okay, you can see the various options available to you. All this allows you to do is to just get it looking a little bit more professional, a little bit more quicker. And when you have it close to what you want it to look like, you can then make various adjustments. Again, just go back to our standard version. The last button to look at is something called Move Chart. What you'll see is if we click on the chart and we click Move Chart, at this stage what we can do is decide the chart is sitting here in the sheet graph elements. We can move it around and put it into any one of the other sheets, or else we can create a new sheet called Chart 2. So when I click here and I say OK, what you'll see happens is the chart is moved out of that sheet into its own sheet. If I want to go back there again, click Move Charts. I'm going to say please put it as object in. I think we're in there. Say okay. And you'll see it puts it back in there. So it just gives you the ability to move your chart around.